The internet is filled with corruption, temptation, and lures to awaken your old man and his deeds. The Bible tells us to put off these things, but our society is forcing everyone onto the internet and causing many to fall prey to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Though the internet may have good uses for some, it can also be a tool of deception and a web of iniquity for others. Many on social media are lonely, disappointed in themselves, hateful and vengeful toward others, and some are just plain deceivers trying to build audiences. Their personal deficits cause them to use social media to hide their true motives or create a virtual existence to hide their failures and true selves. Without true discernment, people allow themselves to be led astray by people who cannot lead anything in real life. But in the virtual world, they portray an image that does not really exist. This is practice for the strong delusion of the beast, and exactly how people will worship an image with no regard for who's behind it. Revelations 13 and 15 says, "And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed." The devil knows that this generation lacks esteem and fortitude more than anything. He knows that many will follow the crowd, the likes, the views, and find satisfaction in things that should be appalling to them. Social media is full of seductive images and alluring videos and corrupt conversations and wicked motives that are waiting to pounce on you and have you bound in the worst possible time. While all of the signs of Jesus' return are being revealed, the devil wants you full of yourself and these devices to keep you from preparing for Christ's coming. Luke 12 and 40 says, "Be ye therefore ready also, for the Son of Man cometh at an hour when ye think not." Through social distancing and stay-at-home orders, the enemy is ramping up his digital kingdom, the very instrument that will unite us all into the hive mind and cloud-based oneness is being forced upon us. We are being made to fully rely on the very medium that will be used for the one world currency, religion, and government to come. We must not give our eyes and ears to every wind of doctrine that comes up on our feeds. We must not allow the enemy to infiltrate our being with the agenda of the Illuminati in this hour. This is the hour for forgiveness, repentance, and holiness. We should be preparing for the return of Christ and living accordingly. This is not the time to allow your heart and your mind to be invaded by things that will bring back your sinful old man. It's time to overcome temptations and fill ourselves with things that are pleasing to God. Fill your hearts and minds with the Word of God and communion of the Holy Spirit. Let it rest, rule, and abide in you. Forsake the gossip, the perversion, the evil that lurks behind certain searches and Google queries. Take a break from the coveting and lusting after what others are tempting you with. Invest in your spirit, man, and strengthen yourself for this final round of this battle. Time is short, and the enemy's plan for you is evil. Read God's word, pray, and fall in love with Jesus so that you will be sure to meet him when he returns. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of a good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things.